Okay, I did my speech over animal testing. According to PETA.org, 100 million animals are tested on around the world each year. This includes dogs, cats, rats, monkeys, and many more. Today, I'm going to persuade you to think about what products you are buying in order to stop this. As an animal lover, this is a real concern of mine, especially because I use makeup on a daily basis. First, I'm going to tell you why it is debated that animals should or should not be tested on. Then, I'm going to tell you why they are being tested on, what products it is used for. Finally, I'm going to tell you the effects of it and why it should be illegal all around the world. And I'm going to tell you what the pros and cons. One of the pros is insulin has saved many lives once it was discovered through the use of a dog's liver. Animals, like humans, have a full body system that runs 24/7 that keeps the body in homeostasis. Homeostasis means that the body is working all together to keep it equal. According to animaltestingprocon.org, in 1988, there were 350,000 cases of polio worldwide. And in 2016, there's only 27 cases. This has spared so many people from this debilitating disease. Some of the cons. Animals behave and communicate different from us. We don't compare to little rats in any way. The animals are deprived from food and water and are forced to be burned, suffocated, and hurt. In the 1950s and 60s, the drug thalidomide, I think that's how you say it, was tested on animals. The drug was used with sleeping disorders. After numerous tests, it passed requirements and was put on shelves for American consumers. The drug was tested on pregnant animals, but only caused adverse effects when it was administered in high doses. At this time, 10,000 babies were born with severe birth defects as a result of this drug. This shows that animals are not like humans, and this isn't a safe way to test drugs. There are two main reasons that animals are tested on: cosmetic and medical reasons. Animals are used to test out drugs and vaccines before they are given to the public. Chimpanzees were used to find the hepatitis B vaccine, and they're now trying to find it for hepatitis C, a deadly disease. A study done by the Huffington Post says that a quarter of all women have been using makeup since age 13. Not all of those products they will use will be animal safe. According to PCRM.org, 72% of people say that using animals for cosmetic testing is unethical. Some of these are great accomplishments, but with that comes consequences. In most cases, they are euthanized once they are used for testing, and even if they're still alive, they're just thrown away like trash. According to OneGreenPlanet.org, animal testing is legal in the U.S., but is illegal in Brazil, India, and the U.K. I think that animals absolutely should not be tested on for cosmetic reasons. We shouldn't be putting stuff into their eyes and into their skin without them being able to give consent. Some medical instances may require it, but I don't fully agree with that either because they are much different. We are much different from animals. I think the animals should absolutely not be tested on. We shouldn't. The U.S. should ban animal testing altogether. First, I told you about why it is debated that animals should or should not be tested on. Then, I talked about why they are being tested on and what products it is used for. Finally, I told you about the effects of the testing and why it should be illegal all around the world. I encourage you to look at the products you are buying and think twice about the things that you really need. Thank you for your time.